My name is Anastasia Matrosova. I come from Ukraine, the south of Ukraine. I'm from Mykolaiv. I'm 37. I have two kids, 8 and 4 years old. I have two boys. Their names are Denis and Dima. On the 4th of March, we had some explosions near my house, and we heard some bombing, we heard a lot of things going on, so it was just next to our house, it was in the city and outside the city, so I made a decision to take my kids and escape from the war, escape from Ukraine. From my native town, from Mykolaiv, I took, my friend drove me to Lviv, and then from Lviv I took a bus, a free bus. I couldn't find any other like transportation, so I used the free bus. So they drove us to the border. Actually, it was 5 kilometers from the border. So then we had to walk, and then we were waiting from 10 p.m. until 6 a.m. to enter Polish border. We were standing outside in a line, a lot of people. It was quite fast because people said that they spent about 3 days in a car, in cars or buses, but it was kind of difficult because we had to walk and we had to take care of kids, and but they had like two tents where we could rest, we could warm up a little bit, so it was okay, we survived. I stayed in Poland for 3 weeks, so volunteers helped me to find a family, because in Poland a lot of families are ready to accept people, and they are really so nice, and they support us Ukrainians so much. So I got the nicest family ever. They really took care of me and kids, and I spent there 3 weeks. But while I was in Poland, my friend from the USA visited me in Poland. They came to Poland and they provided also some help and donations, and they really wanted to take care of me. You know, they said, "You are like a sister to us," my friend and her husband, I mean. So we made this decision to try and get there. We took a plane from Warsaw to Cancun. Then we stayed a night in a hotel, and then we took a flight from Cancun to Tijuana, and here we got to this volunteer center where these amazing people helped us and also provided us with food and shelter, and we were feeling really safe, you know. I was worried that I had to stay outside all this time until we get to the border, but fortunately it didn't happen because of this help. So these are amazing people. I'm so grateful to them, and I think all Ukrainians who got here, they are amazingly, incredibly grateful to these people who help us to survive and to get to America. Back in Mykolaiv, I have my mom, my dad, my brother, my grandma, so that's my family. All of my friends who are of the same age as I am, they all moved to different countries. So it's Spain, Italy, Poland. Just breaks my heart, you know, to read the news, to realize that this is true. Every day I wake up and I want to hear that this is all nightmare, that that was just a dream. But unfortunately, I realize that this is our reality, and that breaks my heart, really. I want to come back home, yeah, when it all finishes. I would love to come back and to see my country alive and successful.